गुड इवनिंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, रामदास मैरिज अ डिस्कशन। द नैरेटर इज कॉल्ड श्यामा। ही हिमसेल्फ एडमिट्स दैट ही इज लाइक अ डार्क पीस ऑफ ऑयल केक। ही लिव्स इन होसाली विलेज। ही इज सैड टू सी दैट हिज विलेज फाइंड्स नो मेंशन इन एनी ज्योग्राफी बुक नॉर अ प्लेस इन एनी एटलस। बट इन हिज ओपिनियन द विलेज हैज सेवरल यूनिक फीचर्स। There are mango trees and creeping plants in the village pond. The best way to know the village is to visit it. Shyama proceeds to tell a story that happened 10 years ago. In those days, not many people knew English. So when the village accountant sent his son Ranga to Bangalore to study, it became news. Naturally, his homecoming after 6 months was also a great event. The news spread like wildfire. The villagers flocked, or rather we can say gathered, to the boy's house to see him. Shyama was also a part of the crowd, but everyone was disappointed. They noticed no change in Ranga. An old lady even ran her hand over Ranga's chest. She was happy to note that the boy had not thrown away the sacred thread. The crowd melted away soon. Shyama then spoke to Ranga, who did a namaskara most respectfully and even touched the narrator's feet. He got the blessing to get married soon. That afternoon, Ranga came to Shyama's house with a couple of oranges. Shyama thought that such a generous fellow must get married, settle down, and be of service to the society. He asked Rangappa, or Ranga in short, when he planned to marry. But Ranga declared point blank that he was not going to marry unless he found the right girl. He had his own rigid views about marriage. It was silly to marry a very young and immature girl. Secondly, a man should marry a girl he admires. He was against the arranged marriage. Shyama was a little put out. Nevertheless, he made up his mind right then to find a match for Ranga. And he didn't have to wait and seek. Ramarao's niece, a pretty girl of 11 years old, had come to stay in the village. She was from a big town. She could play upon the harmonium and sing in a very sweet and melodious voice. Her parents had died. The narrator thought that the girl was the most suitable bride for Ranga. She was called Ratna. The very next morning, the narrator called Ratna as well as Ranga to his house. Ratna was wearing a sari. While she was singing, Ranga also arrived. He stood at the door and looked in. Ratna saw a stranger and stopped suddenly. Ranga was disappointed. He glanced at her repeatedly. The shy girl ran inside. Ranga then inquired about her and asked whether she was married or not. Shyama told a lie that Ratna was married a year ago. Ranga's face contracted like roasted brinjal. Shyama went to Shastriji next morning and tutored him what he was to say to Ranga. That very afternoon, Shyama met Ranga, who seemed lost in thought. But both went to see Shastriji, who was happy to see the boy. As fixed up already, he took out his astrology books and made some calculations. Then he declared that Ranga was thinking about some girl. She had the name of something found in the ocean. They agreed on Ratna as the right girl, the perfect choice for the boy, but Ranga's happiness was short-lived. Shyama repeated that Ratna was already married. They left the place together. On the way, Shyama walked into Ratna's house. He brought happy news for Ranga that the girl wasn't married yet. And the two were united in marriage before long. Several years passed. One day, Ranga came to Shyama's house to invite him to dinner. The occasion was the birthday of his 3-year-old son. They had named the child Shyama as a mark of respect or respect. The other synonym is reverence to the person who had negotiated their marriage. Shyama went to Ranga's house for dinner. As a birthday gift, he placed a gold ring on the child's little finger. Now, if we critically analyze the story, we should note that the story is a first-person narrative and a major portion of the story is in flashback. That is a very interesting thing we have to note, dear students, that the major part of the story or the major portion of the story is in flashback. The speaker directly addresses the reader. The narrator is a neighbor of the protagonist. He introduces the story with a difference by first giving a detailed description of their village Hosahalli. He praises the mangoes from his village. He asks the reader if he or she has ever heard of the village. He replies to the question himself, for the village was not located in any of the maps for the English Babus, and the ones in our country forgot to put it there. He then introduces Ranga, the main hero or the protagonist, in a time 10 years ago. I already told you that the story is in flashback mode. Ranga had gone to Bangalore for higher studies and returned home after 6 months. It was the time when English was a language not popular and a very few people used it. All used to converse in Kannada, that is the local language. The people in Bangalore usually speak in this language. Kannada is their mother tongue. All the villagers arrived at Ranga's place and began scrutinizing him after Ranga returned from Bangalore. However, the narrator stayed back and shared a few jokes with the boy and then left. Later in the afternoon, Ranga arrived at the narrator's home with a few oranges. The narrator judged the boy and felt it appropriate to marry such a well-educated and humble boy. However, Ranga had no plans to settle as a married man. He put his views on marriage in front of the narrator, that he wanted to get married to a girl who is mature and someone Rangappa could admire. Ranga left after the discussion and the narrator decided that he would get the boy married. Determined, he began considering Rama Rao's niece Ratna as the perfect and suitable bride for Ranga. She was from a big town and knew how to play the veena and the harmonium. He came up with a plan. He asked Rama Rao's wife to send Ratna to his place to fetch some buttermilk. So she came on Friday wearing a grand sari. He requested Ratna to sing and send for Ranga. Ranga reached the narrator's place and stopped outside the room as he did not want to disrupt or disturb the singing, but was very much eager, inquisitive, or you can say curious, to see her face, so peeped in. Ratna noticed the stranger and stopped abruptly. Abruptly means, dear students, all of a sudden. Ranga came in and the girl left. Curiously inquired about the girl and the narrator cleverly played at his words. He told Ranga that the girl was married off a year ago and noticed the disappointment flaring Ranga's face. He was infatuated to the girl. The next thing that happened was that the narrator was happy as the plan was working perfectly. As his next step, the next day, the narrator took Ranga to an astrologer. Remember, students, by this time you also know also very well that the name of the astrologer was Sastriji, who he had already tutored what to say. It was the meeting with the astrologer when the narrator's name is disclosed. Shyama he was. The astrologer pretended. Pretend actually means to act falsely. The astrologer pretended to read the natal chart of Rangappa and declared that the boy was in love with a girl with a name of something found in the ocean. Shyama said it could be Ratna, Rama Rao's niece. Ranga's mind was not hidden from Shyama, but the girl was married. The narrator took the boy to Rama Rao's home and asked him to wait outside.
When he came outside, he confirmed that the girl was not married, that there had been some confusion.
After all, the narrator had to come up with something. Even Ranga then admitted that he had been attracted to the girl. Later, a conversation between the astrologer and the narrator is described as how the astrologer says that though the narrator had given him clues, he could have found it all out by himself through astrology. The story finally moves 10 years, or to say returns to the present time. I already told you that the narrator followed the flashback technique here. Rangappa came one day to the narrator, inviting him at his son's third birthday. Shyama is the name of his son. Obviously, Ratna and Ranga had been married, and now they have a 3-year-old son, whom Ranga named after the narrator. That ends the critical part of the story also. Thank you, students.